Hey, this is Shabbats, and we are in Factory Town Tycoon. And in this game, it's a sandbox lumber tycoon that eventually you work into metals, but it starts out primarily lumber. So let's look at the game. When you first start, it'll have a tutorial that you'll build the basics, which is a logs crate like this and a sawhorse to process your lumber. So, as you all know, if you build this, it'll say, oops, I messed up. Build sawhorse, like that. And then you just put those items in there, which takes one log and one processed log. Do I have any logs? Nope. But I have some in my little house over here. Hee hee, I think, yeah. So let's drop one log here. And okay, so here's a plain log it says we need. We're gonna place that in the sawhorse button, use the button. And then this one, to make firewood, I just do that with my axe. And then, bam, I got a sawhorse. And with that, we can now take this log, and instead of chopping it up for firewood, if we use our axe on it, it will make a pillar, one of the basic building blocks of the game. And if you process it again, it makes planks, another basic thing of the game. So let's go back to that build menu. So this game, what they have, these are the recipes that I've unlocked so far. So what you do is you come here to the recipe where I went, because I'm on iPad, I click the Add New Recipe button. And in here is the recipe trees. So you start out with your sawhorse and you'll buy it. Then you can build it anytime you want. And there's a saw, your storage bins. You can see I've unlocked those. And your processing things. And you can also build walls. So you can build a fort. You can build, I've seen somebody up to 3 stories tall building in this game. So you can build up height. And it also, so there's some more, so it has ramps. So you can ramp stuff up to the 2nd floor, unload your cart. So there's all these different recipes, so you buy them. So if I want to do this, buy this furnace, it's $100. Advanced splitter, I haven't needed these things yet, so I haven't bought them. And there's no super dark night. Yay, it's like bright enough to see all the time. I love that. And so I haven't built any of this stuff. So anyway, this is where I have unlocked the things that I need for what I wanted to accomplish. And oh yeah, and also in the build menu, what everybody always asks when it says open plot info panel up in the left, that's where you buy your horses and increase the plot size. And I have 2 more plot sizes I can open up. And I would recommend getting the wagon as soon as you can. You don't get any horses with it initially, but you can move more than one thing at a time, because without your wagon, you're basically going to harvest this tree like this, let's say. So I'll cut the tree down, and then you cut the individual pieces out of it. Let's like pick this branch. Couple of branches. So now let's say I cut all these branches down. So until I get a cart, I'm going to be picking up a log and carrying it back to my sawhorse or my logs crate. I'm going to put it in here and so on. But once you get this cart, even without horses, it's like super slow, but now you have this. Well, you won't get that treasure chest, but you have a flatbed cart, and you can put like 5 logs on it, let's say. Or if you're good at it, you can maybe put more. On the iPad, it's kind of hard to put a lot of logs on there. So anyway, that is a huge, I think it's only $100, and it will really help a lot in the beginning. So that's where you find that. The info plot panel is where you buy this. So you can increase this. I've done all those so far. And this chest was like $1,000, but man, what a help. And you can buy this, which I'm going to buy eventually, but not now. I'm saving up for something else. So that's the basics. Now let me show you some other cool thing. You have this wrench, and what that does is any piece, once you build it and put all the components, like we just did this, it took the logs. Well, now that piece is yours. So I can use my wrench, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on one of these legs so I can change directions of my conveyor belt, and I can also deconstruct it. Now this piece, I can pick it up, I can store it if I need to for a little while, I can pick it up and I can use it over here. And so this whole, like when I had to move one of my loops a little bit, it was super easy. I just deconstructed the whole thing, moved it all over, and it goes really fast. That's a really nice bonus of this game, I think. So let's assemble it. We'll put it right back in there. I'm not great at this, but there we go. And it's the narrow log is the inside. Oh, come on. Sorry. Whoops. Oh, man, I had it. But like I said, this is an early... I'm just glad I can play this on the iPad, and I'm not usually this bad. There we go. Do I have this going the right way? No. Rotate. There. Yay. And I need to use my wrench in reverse. Now all the arrows are going the right way. Okay. So that's that. The next thing it has you build is one of these electric saws. So let's go over to this area and let me grab a log. Oh, I'm low on logs. Uh-oh. So you're going to grab one saw. And what we know from the sawhorse, processing one log turns it into a pillar. So this is my pillar run to run on here. Right? That's how I make pillars. I guess I could have just left that on there. And if it goes through this other saw, it's going to turn into a pillar here. And then when the pillar goes through here, it's going to turn into planks, which is another thing I need for this run. And you can see what I was telling you about being able to easily take pieces in and out. So what I did here is I took this piece out and used these two saws as my processing area. So when I was building this area right here, I had my little lumber output. This was my, I would feed this one to make planks, and I would feed this one to make pillars. And then I took out the corner and they all fell right there. And I had all the lumber I needed right there. So that was one of my basic concepts, try to get things nearby. So from this position, basically, I used to have nail buckets. But anyway, I can pick up a log from there and I can feed it right onto this place. And I can feed it anywhere under here. I can actually feed it right into the carpenter. This one, I usually like grab a log from here. And I feed both stations. And that was my last log for there. And then I feed the station with this. So now I put a pillar and three planks on there that are all going to fall over here, but they usually go in a circle. So that's some of the real, the basic things that you can see once you start building the conveyors that I've accumulated, the corners, a T-joint, a regular conveyor. You put them all together. So I've got my saw going into a T junction to two corners that go into my factory, which is called a carpenter. And then they loop around. So I can put all I want basically on here. It'll loop till it needs it. And then it'll make something for me. And that's what all these basically are, which maybe I'll go into more detail later on. And once you make whatever things you've been processing early on, whether it be logs, so a log, when you sell it in town, is worth $10. If you chop it into fire logs, those are worth $15. Now that you can do right out in the field next to the store to make money early on. You don't have to have a base. You need a base to place your sawhorse, though. So you can stand by the store, harvest a tree, make firewood, and sell it. Or make logs and sell it. If you process it to a pillar, the big piece of lumber, not that, then you can make $17 off your log now. And if you process it into three planks, those are worth $8 each. That's a total of $24 for one log. Then it'll have you buy nails. And nails, you can make more complicated things. Like you'll make a carpenter. That's the name of the device. As a carpenter. And in the carpenter menu, you'll see we can build wood frames, a bed, a bench. And you see we need nails to make a frame that makes any of these. And then we can sell all these things. Benches and tables are worth 57. A bed is worth 150. A window is worth 65, but you need glass and a furnace. So forget about the windows early on. And a wood frame is needed in all of these. So you'll need to buy like a box of nails eventually. You get 10 nails for $30. So if you do some math, you find out a bed is really profitable. So that's why I make crates in this set here, and then I make a bed here, and I just finished my nail factory. And you get a horse and carriage. And yeah, basically you take those goods into your cart and take them to town and start making some money. And then you'll be able to unlock new recipes and upgrade your tools. Because better tools is faster. So I would get the cart first. And probably upgrade my axe after that, soon after. Of course, you're buying recipes. But anyway, cart. And then I'm going to show you town. I think I'm going to wrap this one up. But yeah, if you like just sandbox building things, wow, this game is doing great. Doom, doom, doom. So this is town. So those eight, you get three planks out of one log. That's $24. $17, 10. So you don't have to do anything. You can make $10. And if you harvest a tree, that's like about, I think it's 8 logs. That'd be $80. That's 2 things of nails. Or whatever. Beds. And you see there's a limit on what you can sell, but it goes up pretty fast. Beds are one. So the cost on a bed is like $32 of nails. You make about $118. That's good. This is 4 nails. I forgot my cost per nail. $3 per nail. That's $12. It's a pretty good profit. $45 on both of those, I think. That would be 28-ish. Yep, I think. I don't even know that. I've never made that yet. And this is a pretty good profit. It's a lot of parts, but it's a good profit. Because by then you're making everything. There's nails, $3 each, and then there's where you sell your firewood. Yeah, this game, definitely give it a try if you like sandbox games like this, where you're doing the building and construction. It's got a really good, like I was showing you, deconstruct and put it back together. Fun to harvest the trees. Because I like the way it's like the tree falls. And actually I have experience pruning trees, but anyway, in real life. So it's like I can take out the certain branches I want. So the person that likes trees and knows how they're put together. So I like to like kind of process the tree like this backwards. Anyway, that's just me being silly. Yeah. Oh, there's one hidden inside there. There. So, yeah. Pretty cool game. Oh, yeah, here's the tool place. That thing that says store. That's where you upgrade your tools. And what I did is I ignored all the tools except for the axe early on. I just thought all this stuff is going to be distracting. So I really tried to like focus on making wood products and like learning all like how the conveyors work. And that's why I have what I have so far. So I tried to upgrade this first. I bought this one and this one, and then eventually I'll buy that one. I thought I did at one point. And then eventually I bought this and this so I could start testing those out when I had like a little bit of extra money and I'd start building some things. And then I actually skipped this one because this is pretty cheap, relatively speaking. This, not so cheap. But I'm probably going to skip this one and not spend $2,000. Anyway. So yeah, there's different tools to upgrade as well. So there's a lot to discover in this game. There's, you know, there's all the different nodes around. And really fun building. And it's on computer and iPad. Factory Town Tycoon. Give it a try. Thanks for watching.